Well, good afternoon. Welcome to, for us at least, for the Greenville Choral Society, our first public performance since December of 2019. And we are so glad to bring choral music and great music back to our Greenville and Pitt County communities. And we're so thankful that you've come today. Thank you for joining us. I'm Andy Roby. I direct the concert choir. It's a great honor to work with this group. And I also serve as the Associate Pastor for Music and Worship Arts here at Memorial Baptist, and we're delighted to host this concert today. Thank you for coming. The president of our board this year is Carol Goodwillie, and Carol, come and bring some words to our group.
Thanks so much, Andy. So, as president of the Greenville Choral Society, I want to also welcome you to what is probably our first ever open-air spring concert. So thank you so much for coming. And what a year it has been for everyone, filled with change and hardship and grief and new experiences. And finding ways to continue choral singing is especially difficult in a pandemic, as you can imagine. But thanks to the extraordinary dedication and ingenuity of our three conductors, we have managed to do so with Zoom and outdoor rehearsals, and of course, always with masks. So today is a joyful event, and when we can be with each other and be with you all again. So although the traffic noises you'll be hearing were not meant to accompany the pieces that we'll be singing today, we embrace them gladly as a necessary compromise to share the gift of music with you in a safe way. So we are grateful to our major donors for their continued support, Grady White Boats, the Eddie and Joe Allison Smith Family Foundation, Wells Charitable Trust, the West Memorial Fund, James and Mamie Richardson Perkins Trust, North Carolina Arts Council, and Pitt County Arts Council at Emerge. We are also honored and grateful to the individual donors, many of whom I think are sitting out there right now, who continue to support us in this financially difficult time. So thank you so much. And though this is a joyful day for us, it is also a bittersweet one as we remember our friend Frank Steinbeck, who passed away this year. Frank was a member of the concert choir for more than 45 years. He was a past president of the society, a strong voice in the tenor section, and a dear friend to all of us. We welcome members of his family in the audience today, and we dedicated this concert to his memory. Later in the program, we'll be awarding a scholarship to a promising young musician in his honor. So before we get to the music, which we're going to do right away, just a couple of announcements. You can access the program for our concert by pointing your cell phone at the QR code on signs posted around the lawn. Please do maintain social distancing with other family groups. We hope you can find some shade and be comfortable while we sing. If you need a restroom, you can find one by walking to the right of the church and back through the office entrance to the church. So again, welcome, thank you, and enjoy.
So I'm Paul Flowers. I'm the director of the Children's Chorus and the Bella Voce group. And we are beginning our set today with a piece called I Will Stand Up, written by Andrea Ramsey, who is a pretty famous choral composer in the United States and around the world right now. She actually wrote that piece last year, speaking to the injustices and standing up to injustice for all different kinds of people, and specifically wrote it for 9 different children's choirs in the United States, and we were one of the 9 chosen to sing it. So this is a premiere of I Will Stand Up by Andrea Ramsey.
Thank you.
our next piece, Hutu Shoe Road, features our fiddle player, Miss Laura Ice, and our bass player, which is Jay. What's your last name again, Jay?
Barry.
Jay Barry. All right. So we welcome them. Before we sing our last piece, I do want to recognize the fact that last year we had to end our season early and never get our spring concert. And we typically recognize our eighth graders who would be moving out of the children's chorus because it's fourth through eighth grade and hopefully moving up into the high school group or whatever. So we didn't get to recognize those. And we're also going to recognize our eighth graders for this year. So the youth chorale is right here. So I'm going to ask those of who were you in eighth grade last year, if you would stand up and I will do an announcement. So if you're in, yep, there we go. All right, so I have here, we have Tyson Cook, who was in the group for 5 years. So he started back in fourth grade. He's now in ninth grade. Austin House did it for 3 years. Olivia Perry for 5 years. Jamie Galinas for 5 years. And then Katie Brown for 3 years. So we thank you guys for being in the children's chorus. All right, you can have a seat. And now our current eighth graders, we have Tim Fu, who has been in the group for 5 years. We have Morgan Worsley, this is actually her first year joining us, and we are glad to have her. She's been a wonderful addition to our group. And then we have Emma Anderson, who is in the eighth grade, and she was in the group for 3 years. Let's give them a hand. We are going to end the children's chorus set with a piece called We Are the Music Makers.
Thank you.
So the children's chorus, we, being young and new singers, we didn't take advantage of being able to sing by Zoom or outside because it was it's just too challenging. So we waited until we were actually had the opportunity to rehearse back indoors. So that group literally has only been rehearsing about 6 to 8 weeks. And this group in behind me has actually only been rehearsing about half of that time, trying to pull everything back together once everything opened up. So I'm very proud of the accomplishments of both of these groups in such a short period of time. So now you see before you the Bella Voce, which is some of our children's chorus members and members of our high school group who have sung with the children's chorus and with me for several years. We're going to start our concert with a piece. Called Life Has Loveliness. I tried to find texts that speak to the way that we've been living the last year and give us some hope for enjoyment for a better future soon. And now we're going to end a piece from Shakespeare, Titania's Lullaby.
while we reset the mics and everything, and while we get into place, I wanted to chat with you guys real quick about a couple things. A, this group has been back together since September. We were excited to get back together after our season, like Mr. Flowers said, ended so early last semester, and we were very sad, or last year, and we were very sad that that didn't get to finish out. We were thrilled to be able to use the strategies given to us from a national study, ACDA, the American Choral Directors Association, to be able to come together and to make some music happen again. And we were really lucky that in the fall, it was like 75 degrees through November, so we were able to rehearse outside, and it was great. And if you didn't get a chance to see the winter concert was actually a virtual concert, and it is available on our YouTube page, and it can also be found on our Facebook page as well. A couple notes we forgot to remind you guys. If you don't mind, please make sure that your phones are on silent and not ringing during the middle of the concert. And we've got enough distraction with going by every few seconds. So, anyway, we are so excited to bring some of our pieces to you. We are also excited to have some of our seniors that graduated last year that are still in the area to join us this year. So we will actually recognize our class of 2020 and our class of 2021 later on as we go through. And I'm going to get started. Our first piece is Gate Gate. We chose a theme of peace and hope and healing for our set of music. And it's just some really good music. And the first one is a Buddhist mantra called Gate Gate, which means I will see you on the other side.
Some God's name.
So our next is a good old Dolly Parton favorite, Light of a Clear Blue Morning, and it will feature two soloists and a trio. Our soloists today are Miss Abby Jones and Miss Emily Speakman. So, at this time, we actually have a few folks that will be joining us for this piece. We tried to start a new tradition last year, and then, you know, COVID happened. We decided to start incorporating an alumni piece. So, at this time, I know Jason Costle, you're out there somewhere in the world, and Lindsay Gribble, I know you're out there somewhere in the world, and Jay. And some of our alumni are actually still with us this year because they continued to sing this semester. And this piece is going to be sung at the end of our spring concert every year from here on out. And we will hopefully be joined by some of our alumni as they come to sing with us. So this is And Wherever You Go. Okay, so, anyway, I wanted to, at this time, recognize some of our seniors from last year. So, they're going to give you a wave. Miss Kaylee Singleton, and Miss Rebecca Brown, Mr. BJ Miles, and Mr. Jay Berry, who's playing bass for us today. Let's give them a round of applause. And we would also like to recognize, obviously, the class of 2021, which is a very large class. So if you will hold your applause and find some more people to replace them. Abby Jones, Emma Laughinghouse, Michaela Trankshell, Emily Speakman, Ellery Ivy, Louisa Birch, Haley Schertz, Cabe Copeland, Alex Scanlon, and Royan Garcia. So let's give them a round of applause. And at this point, I would like to invite Kaylee Singleton down to join me for a second. Last year, Kaylee was the recipient of our 2020 Rhonda Fleming Music Study Scholarship. This year, she is a music education major at East Carolina University. Woo woo! Go Pirates! And we wanted to recognize her, and also we wanted her to be here as we awarded our new recipient. We give out the Rhonda Fleming every year to a deserving senior that plans to major in music. And this year we had three very, very qualified applicants, and it was a very difficult choice. But at this time, I would like to recognize Miss Emma Laughinghouse, who's going to be majoring in musical theater at East Carolina. And our last piece that we are going to sing for you is one that we actually had worked on very hard last year, and we were very sad that we didn't get to present it. And we had a fabulous soloist, and we definitely wanted to make sure we could do that. And Mr. Jay Berry decided to come back and play bass for us, and we were also joined by Ms. Laura Ice. And Liam is going to be our fantastic bass, who has had a rough day but made it here anyway, and he sounds fantastic. So this is I'll Be On My Way.
When I am gone, don't you cry for me. Don't you pity my sorry soul. What pain that might have been will now be past, and my spirit I'll be on my way. I'll be on.
Concert Choir is going to share with you a few pieces today. The first two are by an American composer, a black American composer named Nathaniel Dett. Nathaniel Dett was active as a music educator and composer and church musician at the end of the 19th and the first couple of decades of the 20th century. He took a lot of black folk music, African American music. He didn't necessarily so much want to keep it in its original form. He used it as his source material to create new compositions. But you can still hear very strongly the folk traditions from African American and black music that are inherent in his compositions. The first one is really a text that probably is a commentary on the Underground Railroad. Let us cheer the weary traveler. And the second one, a piece that was intended for sacred settings in worship, O Holy Lord.
Let us cheer the weary traveler.
Now we're excited to share with you the entirety of John Rutter's Gloria. John Rutter is a very active English musician, but he spent a lot of time in the United States. He's done a lot of work here. In fact, our ECU chamber singers had a chance to be the featured choir with him at the American Choral Directors National Conference in Kansas City just a couple of years ago, and did a splendid job sharing some new additions that he had arranged, as well as singing some other things. They just represented Greenville and ECU extremely well. We're very proud of them. But we're glad to share with you the work that really brought John Rutter to attention in the United States, this really fine setting of the Latin Gloria from the ancient Mass, exciting setting with brass and percussion and timpani. And what you don't see, it also includes pipe organ, and the great Cassavant organ inside the church is actually what we're going to be using today. But Catherine is in there about 150 feet away from me, and so she's going to be watching on video, and she's going to be heard because of the great work of our sound engineer, Fred Brumbach. Fred, we really appreciate you being able to be with us here and make this outdoor concert possible and let everybody hear everything. Now, we're going to make sure the organ is sounding. We're going to let the brass have a moment to tune, and then we're going to share with you the Rutter Gloria. We have one last number to share with you, and it involves all of our choirs. So the Children's Chorus, Youth Chorale, all of them are coming back up, and we'll take just a moment to reset everything, and then we're going to share with you the last piece of the day. So hold on.
To recognize our new scholarship recipient, we have not done this scholarship before. This is a new one for us. We've given out the Rhonda Fleming to a music study scholarship before, but we've never given it out to a student that was not going to major in music. And we were very sad, as we heard earlier in the program, to lose Frank Steinbeck. I sang next to Frank for many years in the concert choir, and he was a pistol, and we all loved him, and we were very grateful that many donations were made in his honor, or in his memory, to the Choral Society. So we thought a great way to honor him was to make this scholarship in his memory. And so this is the first Frank Steinbeck Memorial Scholarship that we are giving out, and it's going to an incredibly worthy recipient. I've known this individual and his two brothers for a very long time. Mr. Royan Garcia has been with us for 9 years, and we are proud to give him this scholarship. Let's hear it for Royan. And our last piece we will sing for you is When You Believe, which we thought was just a perfect way to end this concert after a very crazy, tumultuous 2020 and start to 2021. And we are proud to sing this. Thank you all again for coming and for being with us today. And thank you for your continued support of the Greenville Choral Society.